हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक टू नवकोकन एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज़ DBJ कॉलेज चिपलून। माई सेल्फ मिस्टर अरुण जाधव, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट एजुकेशन एंड वाटर सिक्योरिटी। एज वी ऑल नो, वी हैव स्टार्टेड आवर सेकेंड लेसन एनवायरनमेंटल पोल्यूशन, एंड इन प्रीवियस सेक्शन वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट एयर पोल्यूशन, इन विच वी हैव स्टडीड वॉट इज़ मीन बाय एयर पोल्यूशन, वॉट आर एयर पोल्यूटेंट्स, what are the sources of air pollution, what are the impacts of air pollution on human health and on environment, and we have also talked about preventive measures, control measures of air pollution. And today we are going to discuss one of the very important environmental issues, that is climate change. So in climate change we are going to talk about what is meant by climate change, what is meant by greenhouse effect, what is meant by global warming, and what are the impacts of climatic changes. So let us start today's session with definition of climate change. Now, definition of climate change is the change in the general average weather pattern in a place over period of years. So climatic changes take number of years. Climatic change is not the change that is seen in last 2 or 3 years. Climatic changes are the changes that are seen since last 50 or 100 or more than 100 years. So this is what climate change is. It is nothing but a change in a general average weather pattern in a place over a period of years. Man-made changes have greater and more serious impacts on the climate. Human activities are leading to an unprecedented acceleration in climatic changes. It is predicted that by 2050, the world will be warmer by an average of 1.5 to 4.5 degrees Celsius. So, in next 30 years, temperature of the globe will be rise by 1.5 to 4.5 degrees Celsius. There are several reasons for these accelerated changes. The increase in some gases in the atmosphere resulting from human activities such as burning of fossil fuels, deforestation, industrialization are some of the reasons. As these emissions continue to rise, it is feared that they will lead to a substantial change in the climate. So this is all about climate change. Now, in climate change, one of the very important aspects is greenhouse effect. So let us talk about greenhouse effect. We all are familiar with this concept, greenhouse effect. So here in greenhouse effect, the earth surface absorbs solar radiations, the heat which is coming from the sun. So some amount of heat is absorbed by the earth. So heat radiations are absorbed by the earth surface, while some of the heat is radiated back into the atmosphere. Not all the heat is absorbed, some amount of heat is radiated back, is re-emitted back into the atmosphere. Naturally occurring gases trap the part of outgoing heat, which leads to warming of the earth's surface and substantial rise in the temperature of the troposphere. And this substantial rise in the temperature of the troposphere is nothing but greenhouse effect. Now in greenhouse effect, role of greenhouse gases is very important. Let us try to understand this greenhouse effect with the help of diagram. So here we have a diagram of greenhouse effect. So let us try to understand how does greenhouse effect work. So here is the earth surface, here is the sun, and these are the radiations, heat radiations coming from the sun. Now these heat radiations coming from the sun are absorbed by the earth surface. And as discussed earlier, not all the heat is absorbed by the earth surface. Some amount of heat is radiated back into the atmosphere. And this radiated heat, re-emitted heat, is trapped by the gases present in the lower atmosphere like carbon dioxide, methane, ozone, nitrous oxide, water vapors, CFCs, etc. These gases are termed as a greenhouse gases. They are present in the lower atmosphere, and role of these greenhouse gases is to trap re-emitted heat radiations by the Earth's surface. These gases act as a blanket. They act like a glass. They allow heat radiations to pass through towards the Earth's surface, but they do not allow re-emitted heat radiations to go into the space. So this is how these greenhouse gases act as a blanket, due to which temperature of the Earth rises. And this rise in the lower atmosphere, this rise in the Earth's surface temperature is nothing but greenhouse effect. Now, this greenhouse effect or this phenomenon keeps the Earth sufficiently warm, and the life on the Earth survives at this temperature. It means this greenhouse effect is very essential for the survival of many living organisms, because this greenhouse effect provides suitable conditions of temperatures for the survival of many of the living organisms. And therefore, we can say that greenhouse effect is very useful for survival of many of the living organisms, as it keeps the Earth warm. Now, gases like carbon dioxide, oxides of sulfur, oxides of nitrogen, methane, etc. are called greenhouse gases, because they act like a glass or blanket in greenhouse effect, due to which the heat absorbed by the surface of the Earth is retained and it cannot escape into the space. This trapping of heat in the troposphere is nothing but greenhouse effect. So this is all about greenhouse effect. Let me remind you, in greenhouse effect, role of greenhouse gases is very important. These greenhouse gases are emitted out from various human activities also. Carbon dioxide is naturally present in atmosphere, while carbon dioxide is also adding to the atmosphere due to human activities. Other gases like methane is adding to the atmosphere in both the ways, that is like from natural processes and from human activities also. So these greenhouse gases are emitted out from natural and man-made processes. If we compare natural and man-made processes, then man-made activities are largely responsible for emission of these greenhouse gases. It means due to excessive human activities, due to increased industrialization, urbanization, greenhouse gases are emitted out into the atmosphere in excessive amount. And this excessive emission of greenhouse gases leads to global warming. So let us talk about global warming, one of the very important environmental issues. Now, global climate is dependent on the concentration of greenhouse gases present in the Earth's atmosphere. Today, human activities leading to the release of greenhouse gases are dramatically increasing. Vehicular and industrial emissions are adding gases like carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, oxides of nitrogen, carbon monoxide, and so on. Some new man-made gases such as CFCs are also responsible for increase in temperature. The gradual increase in the temperature of the Earth's surface or atmosphere due to excessive emission of these greenhouse gases is referred to as global warming. So global warming is nothing but a gradual rise in temperature of the Earth due to excessive emission of greenhouse gases. So this is all about global warming. Now, after talking about global warming, let us talk about very important thing, that is impacts of climatic changes. Climate change is having various impacts on human health as well as on environment. Let us discuss all the impacts in detail. The first impact is temperature increase. If input of greenhouse gases continues to rise at the present rate, Earth's mean temperature will rise by 1.5 to 4.5 degrees Celsius by 2050, as we discussed earlier. This would disrupt crop growth and cause loss of agricultural production. Here we are having a diagram which tells us how is temperature rising continuously. Global temperature increased since 1850. So this graph is about global temperature increase since 1850. So since 1850, we can see the continuous rise in temperature of the earth. So this is how temperature is rising, which results in various health and environmental issues. So this is the first impact of climatic changes. Now the second important impact is rise in sea levels. Over the last century, the global sea level has risen by 10 to 30 centimeters. Due to melting of glaciers and ice sheets, the sea level is continuously rising. If this situation continues, this would submerge small islands. The Republic of Maldives is an example of a nation which is very vulnerable to sea level rise. Delta regions are also at high risks. Especially coastal regions are at high risks due to sea level rise. Here we have a data showing how is sea level rising. In this diagram, we can clearly see that from 2005 to 2015, how is the sea level rise. So this is how sea level is rising day by day, due to which existence of coastal cities is in danger. Coastal cities are at high risk. So this is the second impact, that is rise in sea level. And as discussed earlier, this sea level is rising due to melting of glaciers. So melting of glaciers is mainly responsible for sea level rise. Here we can see in this picture how are glaciers melting, due to which sea level is continuously rising and the coastal cities are at high risk. Now the third important impact of climate change is impacts on agricultural production, loss of agricultural production. Changes in weather pattern would have far-reaching effects on agriculture. Some places would get drier, some wetter, some get hotter, and other cooler. This will affect the crop production and yield. At present also, we can observe the situation of monsoon in Maharashtra, in India, in which some areas are drier, still drier, they haven't received rainfall yet. So the changes in monsoon pattern are leading to reduction in agricultural production. So in future also, this agricultural production will be badly affected due to climatic changes. So this is the third important impact, that is impacts on agricultural production. Now the fourth important impact is loss of ecosystem and biodiversity. Due to large-scale felling of trees and high level of dryness, large forests may catch fire. Indonesia and Brazil forests are the recent examples of forest fires. Large areas of forests would disappear, so animal species would be forced to migrate. Recently, we have experienced the forest fire in Amazon, where we have lost thousands of species of living organisms along with plants. So due to such a kind of forest fires, there is a huge loss of ecosystems and biodiversity. And all this is happening because of climatic changes. If we talk about Amazon fire, then it was not natural, it was man-made, but such a kind of forest fires are expected to rise, or the incidences of such a forest fires are expected to rise in future due to climatic changes. The last very important impact is adverse effects on human health. Human health is also adversely affected due to climatic changes. Deaths due to heat waves and other extremes of climatic conditions, water and airborne diseases like malaria and dengue, etc., would be more. So with changes in climate, there is a possibility of increase in the diseases like malaria and dengue. Climatic changes is having impact on physical and mental health of the people. So climate change is having impacts on environment, on plants, animals, as well as on human health. So this is all about the impacts of climatic changes. So here in this session we have talked about climate change, in which we have seen definition. Then we have talked about greenhouse effect, which maintains the temperature balance of the earth. Then we have talked about global warming, and in the end of this session we have seen impacts of climatic changes. Thank you.